I'm now sharing my screen to show you some sample app code and also where you can get this code and walk through some of the processes that you will need to be familiar with to get up and running with PingOne for Customers. So the first thing that I'm going to do is show you this PingOne for Customers admin console. If you signed up for our free trial, you're already familiar with this and you've logged in here. And you see we have different metrics on our dashboard and then different sections across the top that we can go to. So the first thing that we're going to do is look at our first bit of sample code. I'm going to open another tab here and go to github.com/pingidentity. And here we have our different apps that are available. And if we go to, if we search by customers, since this is PingOne for Customers, we can find this first sample app. And this is our JavaScript authentication quick start. This is available right now for all of you to find. And you can go download this and do exactly the same thing that I'm going to walk through now. So the way that this works is the first thing that we need to do is create an application instance that we will use to connect our sample code to. The way we do that in our admin console is by going to the connections up here and selecting add new application. In this case, we're going to make a single page app. So I'll select that here and click configure. And then let's just give this a name. We'll call it webinar test. For a description, oh, here, webinar test. Webinar testing, I think I have webinar test already. And for a description, let's just say testing 1, 2, 3. And we'll click next. For our redirect URLs, I'm going to be testing this particular application on the local Apache web server on my Mac. And I've configured that to be at HTTP local host. That's enough for now. And we'll click save and continue. Now we need to add a few different scopes to the application. In this case, we'll just keep it simple and we'll just use the OpenID scopes.
Yep. And I would say just to orient you, if you're not familiar with identity nomenclature, scopes are just the things that help you control what areas of the application that a particular user is going to have access to as they log in.
Yeah, that's right, Dustin. And right now we're just going to add these simple OpenID standard scopes, but notice this huge list of additional scopes that are provided for PingOne for Customers. Very granular and very powerful. We'll see where some of those are in use a little bit later. So now that I've selected these four scopes, I'm just going to click save and close. And we have created our application. It's this one up here, webinar testing. And we have not enabled it yet. So notice this little switch here. I'm going to have to flip this to turn it on. And now our application is live. So now for this next part, let's look at some sample code. The application that I just looked at on GitHub, I have downloaded and opened up here. And there are just a few files in there. The ones that I really want to point out is first auth.js. As a developer, you don't have to do anything with this, but you can see this is sort of our proto SDK for this JavaScript example. It has functions that we've created in here that connect to the different APIs that PingOne for Customers does provide. All we really need to do to configure this sample app, though, is go over to our index.html and scroll down to the bottom to where the configuration is asking for a few different things, our environment ID, our client ID, and then some redirects for login and logout. So let's go get this information. I'm going to switch back over to my admin console, and let's open up the details of this application we just created. We can see that our client ID is listed right in here. So I'm going to copy this, switch over to my code. I'm going to paste it in to this client ID section. So I got a little white space there. Okay, so that's that. Now we need our environment ID. That's available a couple different places in here, but the main place is if we go over to settings. This is global for this entire environment. Here's our environment ID right here. So we'll go over and paste that in here. So the eagle-eyed developers among us might have noticed that this code also appears in things like this URL up here. Over here on our connections, again, if we open up our webinar testing, all of the different endpoints that we use for various functions, you can see our environment ID is right in there. So that's a nice little reminder of where that is. And then we can also see down here on the bottom, I've configured the redirect to localhost. So let's go back over to our code and our redirect. Instead of localhost with this port on here, We'll just pop that off of both of these. We're going to purely localhost for this example. Okay, so then we can save this code, and let's open it up in our other web browser here. So I have a Safari window where I have traveled to localhost, and I can see that this code is running right here. So we can go and click here to sign on. But before we do that, we're going to need a user account to test this sign on. So let's go back to our admin console. Let's go over to the users section, and we'll click the add user button. So for this, let's just call this person first name webinar, and for their family name, test. And then there are lots of other details we can enter here. And this is all configurable, by the way. So if you don't need some of these, or if you need additional entries here, you can configure that for your applications. But we do need to enter our username down here. So let's call this webinar test. And skip everything else and click save for now. So our user is created here. Before we jump back and try to log in for this test, let's reset the password. So we do specify a password for this. And I will, in this case, just set something simple and click save. Now we'll go back over to try our test. We're going to click to sign on. And in this case, this is the simplest use case. We've configured this to use the Ping Identity provided default login form. And we will just try out here, webinar test and the password that I entered. And we'll click sign on. And this is the first time that we're using this, so it's asking us to change to a new password, just as a normal new user might. So I'm going to put in the password that I chose. And then off screen, I'm going to go copy a new complicated password that I can start to type in here. You'll notice the minimum password requirements. You know, as we start to type this in, you know, the use or the different requirements are met. Well, I know I'm just going to paste in one that I know does a good job. And the same one here, and click save. So we've reset our password to a new password that the user has chosen, and we've logged in. You can see here we're logged in as webinar test, and lots of other information that we entered in here, you know, the user's details. But in particular, of interest to you developers will be the token details down here, the tokens for this session where we have authenticated. And just for fun, let's just use the inspector and go and look at the some of the storage here. And you can see here in our session storage, all of this information is available in here to pull out for use in your own app.